Hey everybody, my name is Philip Jet and welcome back to another episode of Danganronpa Trek Happy Havoc. In the last episode, we found some clues with the help of Byakuya. After that, we finally got rid of him. Fucking douchebag. We're just going to check out the girls' locker room ourselves for some clues. Alrighty, Yuvimi, what do you have to say? Ding 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 ding! Yuvimi has discovered evidence revealing the identity of the culprit.
I feel as if...
Another stat increase for me. Evidence? What did you find? I cannot reveal that just yet.
That's it. I'm sure
But I can guarantee that what I found was stealing the killer's craft from his lungs. Are you sure about that? Yeah, Miss Lunenburg said she'd witnessed something worthwhile too. Really, what did she see? She refused to tell me. It's like when a girl bullies the boy she likes, right? Right? Okay, so where is Celeste now? The man was by the girl, she was there. But at the same time, not there. What's it gonna be? Alright, so Hifumi knows something. Dopey little fucker. Don't really care about him though. Let's see. Just want to check everything again. No, not that. Just want to check. This has to be something, no? Okay. Hey Kyoko, have you made any progress on your investigation? Generally speaking,
however,
we have to get going. I have something unrelated to take care of. Something besides the investigation? What is it? Nothing you need to worry about, just concentrate on the murder. But
so then,
before I go, let me give you one piece of advice. You should examine Chihiro's bodies one more time thoroughly. Also, her handbook is missing. You might want to determine its whereabouts. That's it, I'll be praying for your success. With that, Kyoko turned and left the girls' locker room. Guess I'll take another look at the body then. And Chihiro's handbook is missing? That's definitely worth worrying about. Chihiro's handbook has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Alright. Let's check the body again. I know she's a thoroughly, but I do have my limits. Well, I'd better give it a shot anyway. Let's see. Chihiro's hands are bound with what looks like some kind of rope. The rope is used to prop her up in a kind of crucifix position. The rope has a block. Oh. Alright, wait, so then this isn't a rope at all. But the more I think about it, the more it's not the only thing that concerns me. Go to the head. Yeah, I assumed. Not too much about either of them. But seeing them again as looking to the genocide check file, something's not quite right. What does this all mean? Signs of the bad body, alright? Well, the one thing most likely to tie all these mysteries together is the true nature of the rope that was used to spend that's a series I need to visit and look over again. Visit that mark to look at the genocide check case files one more time. Alright, let's talk to Sakura.
Damn!
Chihiro's presence here was especially weak. Her body and her soul.
No forgiveness!
The target set you help us being it's unforgivable. What a wretched beast to do such a thing. I cannot forgive this. Alright, let's see back to you. Do that a real complex around me. Yeah, same old stuff. Alright. I think that's all the things we need from here. I mean, there's a blood in the carpet. Was that added to my... Wait, was that added to my clues or not? No. But it was something of interest. Oh, that's the pool door. Oh, okay. Alright, let's go into the boys' bathroom. Locker room, I mean. Oh. Interesting. This is a different poster. It's a popular boy band called Tornado. Somehow it doesn't quite seem to fit in the boys' locker room. Oh, but wait, that reminds me. The boys in the other locker room is. That's right, there's definitely something strange about this. In the boys' locker room, there's a poster of a popular boy band. In the girls' locker room, there's a poster of the big breasted swimsuit model. Could the posters have been switched? Yes, they were. Maybe I should talk to someone who knows a little more about the locker room. Monokuma, hello? And there's something interesting about this carpet. There's a strange stain on this carpet. What is it? Alright. So, thinking about that, the murder happened in the boys' locker room. Let's see, so I think what happened is that they used Leon's handbook. Don't know why they used theirs. Wait, what was Chiro doing here then? More questions are popping up. Oh, I still need this couple more. Alright. Oh, I guess I should ask about the locker room. No. You don't have anything to say, maybe you?
Of course.
Ah, I've used it nearly every day since Dope It Up. Sometimes Sina and I use it together. Okay, then let me ask you something. Do you think the posters in the boys and girls locker rooms could have been switched?
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I can't really say. I never really paid any attention to the posters.
However.
But there is something that's been bothering me about the locker room. You see, I like to drink a little protein coffee every time I finish exercising. We have protein coffee? In the warehouse, it's not the highest quality. But I don't have a lot of other options. I mix protein powder with coffee and down a glass of it after exercising. Anyway, the other day I spilled some on the carpet in the girls' locker room and it left a stain. Oh, stain? But I don't see any stain on the carpet now. The stain has disappeared. I can only show come on and clean it up. Never stain to begin with. Well, we found that stain. And I think we know a person that would actually pay attention to the poster. But let's step right. If you might recall, we have someone who has a certain affection towards 2D ladies.
Da-da-da-da-da! I feel it.
That's it.
Right?
Well.
No. No, he doesn't want to talk about it? Alright. I just want to check on the stain again. Maybe he will link it together. There's a strange stain on carpet, what is it? Alright, he doesn't link it together, never mind. That should be it then. Alright, that's it. Okay, good. Let's see, let's try to find Celeste. Oh, we don't see. Wait, no, that's a different room. Wait. Alright, Celeste is in the warehouse then. Alright, we'll go there a bit later. But first, let's go to the library. I mean, we're on the same floor at all. I mean, I did notice the cord missing, but Yakuya was like, no, that's not important. this Byakuya murder. I mean, he seems to be the only one who knows about the case. Alright. He's the only one that knows about these case files. So, I don't know. Yeah, you're not going. Okay. I want to take another look at Genocide's chat case file. I know it was around here somewhere. It's gone. Did someone take it out of the archive? But the only one who would do something like that. I can't think of anyone but Byakuya. But to be fair, why would he then do the investigation with me? I guess the fact that we know the Y is missing from the library is not important. There's still more I need to check. I don't know, the letter? But if we can figure out why they would want to push us all here, well, that would be enough to cast out here. Or not really anything important. The lamp itself, maybe? Huh? The lamp won't turn on. Oh, I see, it's not plugged in. The lamp's cord is long enough to reach the other thing, but it was definitely right here. Oh, that's right, Byakuya was using an extension cord. Yeah, no shit. Oh my god, he's really stupid. I wonder if... he's stupid. But I can leave the area now. Like, checking the place where the extension cord would be doesn't make it happen. The plug, like the outlet doesn't happen. It's not connecting to him, no. The fucking lamp itself is like, oh yeah, extension cord. Fucking idiot. Alright, map time. I wanna go to Celeste. This is the warehouse, right? I mean, she's just there. I don't know what Hifumi was about. Celeste, what are you doing here? This warehouse is amazing. It has absolutely everything one might need to live a full life. From food to clothes to towels, there's an endless supply to choose from. I see that, but have you found anything related to the case?
Most unfortunate.
I knew you were going to ask me that. I thought talking about the warehouse itself might misdirect you, but I see it was pointless. Then you did find something. Very well, I will tell you, and only you. Last night I saw her here. Chihiro was in the warehouse. What? Really? This was right before nighttime.
What are you doing out this late?
Oh, I was just...
Are you planning to go exercise, perhaps?
What? How did you know?
Because I can see a blue track jacket sticking out of that duffel bag you're carrying.
Oh, you're right. Thanks. Well, I'd better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
She stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And just like that, she was gone.
Yes, indeed.
I assumed she was merely stocking up to go exercise in the morning, but... it would appear she ignored the nighttime rule and headed directly to the girls' locker room. If she hadn't broken a rule, none of this ever would have happened. You get what you deserve, I suppose. Oh, you bitch. So apparently, she went to the girls' locker room late at night in order to exercise without anyone knowing. We kind of figured that out because of the time of death, but sure. Look at the doctor, let's use... Oh, yeah. It's annoying. That is true. We might want to check the trash room again. trail somewhere around here, right? Yeah, this way. I mean, I doubt that it's been used again, but it doesn't hurt to check. It's still closed. Yeah, that's true, I guess. But there is a hatch here. I don't know, that's still interesting to me. I still also have no clue of on who the killer could be. I have a sneaky suspicion, but I'm not certain. Alright, what do I want to check now? Let's review the evidence. Actually, there was a exclamation mark in the dining hall, if I remember correctly, with Ina. Alright, so let's talk to you. Oh, Ina, how's Toko doing? Same as before, she won't come out. And she just keeps on mumbling something about genocide Jack. So I just left it there. You left her? My head was all swimmy and I was getting pretty hungry. Oh, but don't worry, I'm gonna head back as soon as I'm done eating. Toko's not exactly pleasant, but I'm still worried about her. Speaking of which, what are you eating? A donut, of course. Of course. There's two things I'm sure God created, outer space and donuts. Really? I bet Chihiro would have liked to eat more donuts. Maybe that was her one big regret. I should have tried to spend more time with her. Come to think of it, who did she spend time with? Yeah, she was a little bit strange, didn't really hang out with the other girls much. It was like she was trying to keep a distance from us. Actually, Sakura said something similar. She said that even though you and her invited Chihiro to exercise with you, she always refused.
Yeah, totally.
Yep, it's true. And it wasn't just us, either. It was like she stayed away from all the girls. Was she just shy? I don't know, she talked to the boys all the time. Isn't it kinda weird to be shy around your own sex, but totally fine with the opposite sex?
Ah!
Oh wait, maybe. Maybe she was used to guys spoiling her. The law says you can't judge a book by its cover, right? You think so? I never really saw her as that kind of girl. Oh? What's this?
I'm getting tired of waiting. Shall we just plunge right in? It's the moment you've all been waiting for! The class trial! You remember where to meet, right? Please go through the red door on the first floor of the school.
It's time already for that?
See you soon!
I actually have no clue on who it could be. Except for sneaky suspicions that I'm not going to say outright. Okay.
So, is everyone ready to...
What?
Am I blind or are we missing someone?
Yo.
Yeah, Toko's not here.
Huh? And Toko is...
You really don't remember?
Come on!
Kidding, I'm just kidding. How could I forget that little nut job? She's a crucial part of the class trial this time.
What are you gonna do?
Oh, okay, okay. I'll go ahead and take her out here. Kicking and screaming. Just one moment, please.
Just like he said, a few minutes later, he appeared dragging Toko behind him. I told him I didn't want to, but he forced me. I can't believe you would drag a girl around. Terrible. You're terrible.
So, now's everyone here, right? Okay then. Hustle onto the elevator and let's get this show on the road. I'll see you guys down there.
Let's go.
So, shall we get going? It's time to find out who killed Chihiro. Chihiro Fujisaki.
She was so gentle, so calm and meek. Nobody had any problems with her. No. No one had. Someone made the choice to kill. A girl like that. Yeah, it wasn't even out of hate or anything. And that murderer is one of us. Someone standing right here. Alright, so. Suspicions. I don't think it's Mondo. I don't think it's Taka. I don't think it's Yuffie. I don't think it's Hiro. I don't think it's Sakura. I also don't think it's Kyoko. The only one that I'm suspicious of is Byakuya and Toko. First, I don't think they did this murder. We have no choice, right? We have to do
this.
Yes. I gave a small nod in reply. The fondness deep breath, I walked towards the elevator on shaky legs. Unfortunately, since the elevator is not arrived yet, I fell right through the hole. With each step forward, I could feel my heart starting to race faster and faster. As soon as everyone was on, the elevator began to descend. I couldn't get a handle on my emotions. Couldn't stop speculating. The steel box sank with heavy clunking sounds deeper and deeper into the ground. The elevator was unaffected, however, and continued until finally... I think we read it before.
What do you think? I redecorated. Isn't it so fresh? Isn't it so exciting?
Don't waste your time, you stupid questions. Let's get this over with.
Good. You're raring to go. Gotta say, I don't hate it. Not at all.
Well?
Okay then, let's get the show on the road.
Chills, chills, kills!
Everyone, please find your assigned seats.
And so the curtain opened once again. A deadly widow, deadly defense, deadly faith. A deadly class trial and a deadly dead people. Let's save our data. Alright, I see we have still more time left to keep the episode going. Set skills. What's this? Increase time limit for each phase. Effective to... why not. Let's pick the other one. The rest we don't have. I mean, we can check our truth bullets, but... Okay, I don't feel prepared for this one at all. Like, the other one was much clearer. So, I'm going to really pay attention to this.
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results. If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate. Okay, then. So, first off, let's talk about the murder weapon!
First, we have to make clear what was used to deliver the fatal blow. And that shouldn't be too difficult.
Chihiro's fatal injury. It appears it was a head wound.
Yes. According to the Monokuma file, the killer used a blunt instrument. But what kind of blunt instrument could it have been?
I bet it was an iron pipe.
Nope. Dude, don't make guesses like that. What the fuck? Guess for the sake of the game, we had to make a guess.
Can we agree
so, like, we
that
could
the
do
object
this,
that
but...
dealt the fatal blow was the dumbbell found at the scene of the crime? It was covered in blood, and there was nothing else at the scene that could have caused that kind of injury.
And the wound on the victim's head is consistent with the shape of the dumbbell. As far as I'm concerned, there's no mistake and no room for doubt on this one.
You looked at her head wound?
Yay! That's so creepy!
If you don't mind, I will proceed from here. Let's move on to discussion of the culprit. Although, I believe the criminal behind this heinous act is already quite clear.
What? For real?
Chihiro's killer is... the fiendish serial killer, Genocide Jack.
Genocide Jack, de vierde serie killer. Did he really kill Chihiro? Oh, new element? Oh, fine, absolutely, tell me about it. For this debate, lines of white noise will appear to disrupt your reactions. Your truth bullets will disappear if they hit these lines, so think of them as obstacles in your debate. But there's a way to keep this white noise from getting in your way. Press the X button to attach the silencer, which you can use to shoot down the white noise. However, if you shoot an actual remark with your silencer instead of the white noise, the time limit will decrease, so take careful aim when you have your silencer out. Oh, but if your action difficulty is set to gentle, white noise won't appear at all. In any case, you can forget about silencer and just focus on the situation in front of you. Well then, good luck and have fun. Well, I have it on kind, so that should be not the problem. There's also an achievement for getting like 500 of those. Alright, so...
The culprit is Genocide Jack. I'm sure. Case closed, as far as I'm concerned.
But that's impossible!
Why? What makes it impossible?
Well, I mean, come on! There's just no proof for it.
Case closed.
No, that's wrong!
Alright, nice, nice. Now I don't really care about my... making
might
a mistake that
one
much.
Reason he could be involved.
Because I got the achievements, but I still want to it. Well, good.
What?
I found this file while I was looking around the archive in the library. I guess it's some kind of confidential file the police put together about the genocide.
What? That's kind of weird as shit, isn't it? What was something like that doing in the library?
The why of it is probably more trouble than it's worth. So let's forget about that for now. More importantly, it outlines all the specifics of every Genocide Jack case in exceeding detail. According to the file, there appear to be two defining characteristics in every Genocide Jack case. The first is that a bloody message is found written at the scene of every murder.
Oh, that's right. Boob lust.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
No. It's actually bloodlust.
But more important is the other characteristic, and it's something that has never been made public.
Never made public? What the hell is it?
Why don't you tell them, Makoto?
The other characteristic of every Genocide Jack case, which the world at large doesn't know, if I'm not mistaken, it has to do with the positioning of the body. No, nope. It's like right there in the text. What kind of puzzle is this?
Apparently, in every Genocide Jack case, the killer suspends the body in a certain way. Other than the killer, the only people who know about this are the higher-ups in the police department.
However, Chihiro was most definitely suspended in the same way. So, how did the culprit know about this when only high-level police officials were aware of it? There's only one logical answer I can think of. It's because the culprit in this case is the real Genocide Jack.
No fucking way!
You're saying Genocide Jack is one of us?
Yes. In fact, it's Toko.
What?
Genocide Jack's true identity is Toko Fukawa.
Well then, I think with that cliffhanger, I'm going to end this episode. This was actually one of my suspicions, and it weirdly makes sense. And she totally changed when she saw blood, like, not in a good way. But in the next episode, we're going to delve deeper into this theory. I just really don't know who it could have been. I think it's either Toko or Byakuya. Well, anyway, see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.